decided to crap out on me again. So, let's try it again.
Your mom craps out on you.
Fuck!
I'm your cousin.
Well, you know what?
What?
You're gross for thinking that way.
Your mom's actually the one that said it first, and I was like, ew.
That doesn't even make any sense. It's like, it's fuck you, not I'm going to fuck you. That doesn't even make any sense. Like, why would people think that? Oh, you said fuck you? Well, that must mean you want to fuck me. No, that's not what that means.
I mean, when you say it like you just said it, it actually makes perfectly sense why they would say that.
I don't understand.
You said fuck you? Literally says fuck and to you. It makes sense.
No, it doesn't.
It makes logical sense.
It doesn't make
any
logical sense.
I mean, it doesn't make practical sense. Like, we all know that's not what the person was saying. But logically,
that's not
the
even
words
like,
arranged in such a manner.
That's not even grammatically correct, though. I don't know. So yeah, the stream crapped out, and I lost all of my audience, and by all of my audience, I mean, like, four people, and they do. One of them made a really nice fucking drawing of me, and I really, really like it. It looks like me in the Scott Pilgrim universe. And I fucking love Scott Pilgrim, so that made me fucking sweet, man. Like, Magikat, if you're watching this, that's a fucking awesome drawing. That's a really good drawing. So yeah. I gotta figure out where I was going. Shit. I need to find the shield key. There we go, Magikat's back.
I love you forever if you can wheel your chair that way and I can list it in the plastic chair and play on your computer.
Okay.
And, of course, doing this.
No. Oh, okay.
There you go.
I see what you're doing.
Yeah.
Alright. It, like, I don't know if you heard me earlier, Magikat, but that drawing kicks all kinds of ass.
Ooh.
Like, seriously, like, I squeed when I first saw it.
Like a little girl.
Like, no, I did. I'm like, oh my god, this fucking drawing's so good.
And then he saved it.
Yeah, I saved it.
It's gonna go on YouTube.
Chairs in here. This room is small enough.
I would have taken it with me when I left.
But no, seriously, Magikat, like, thank you for that. Like, that is such an awesome drawing. Like, I would even go as far to say, like, dude, like you should, like, seriously, like, make my channel art or something like that.
I mean, why don't you just get down on your knees right now, Zach?
Oh, shut the fuck up. I'm complimenting his or her drawing.
I know, it was very nice. I was being a dick.
Well, I mean, if you're only 14, like, you got a pretty bright future ahead of you, like, just becoming, like,
stick with it.
Yeah, no, seriously, stick with it. Like, become, like a graphic novel artist or something.
Or at least keep it as a hobby.
Yeah, like, no, yeah, seriously.
Become, like, a lawyer that does art on the side, and everyone has no idea.
Yeah.
Have you beat the game yet?
No. I'm far from beating the game.
I need to get ahead of this.
God damn it, Mariah, it's too loud.
I'm getting headphones.
The audience doesn't want to hear you playing Fallout 4.
Maybe they do.
Maybe they don't. Maybe because Fallout 4 is a fucking rancid-ass game that no one likes.
Your mom's a rancid-ass game no one likes. I'm sorry, I shouldn't talk about my aunt like that.
Plan on becoming an animator or character designer. I can see that.
Computers.
Like, when I looked at it, it was like, if you've ever read, like, the graphic novel Scott Pilgrim, like, you made me into a Scott Pilgrim character.
Very, very Pilgrim.
Which is awesome, because I really love Scott Pilgrim.
Doesn't everyone good taste?
Yeah, I mean, Scott Pilgrim's fucking kick-ass. Mr. Scott. Scott Kennedy. Goddamn right you made me happy. It's a fucking
awesome.
He's so
gay right now.
Fuck you. Wait, you don't even know if it's a girl
happy.
Or a boy.
No, I'm saying gay means happy. You said he made you happy. I was being literal.
Oh, well, alright.
Get your mind out of the gutter.
Get your mind out of the fucking gutter.
Huh?
Nothing.
No, can't hear you. I have headphones on. About the Brotherhood to steal this bitch. Right,
yeah,
on,
see,
girl
she's
power.
Girl. Yeah.
Girl
power.
That's why she's such a good artist. Girls are so much better artists than guys.
Hey, fuck off now. Don't be sexist. Oh, shit.
Ow, fuck. See? You never see rancid...
No, don't move shit. What the fuck are you doing, Jill? Okay.
You never see rancid-ass cats attacking you in games like this. It's always dogs. Because dogs are evil.
Now you're being
awesome.
Racist against cats.
And because cats are smart enough not to get infected in the first place.
Now you're being,
like,
now you're being racist against dogs.
Yep. Hate dogs.
Racist.
Well, I don't hate all dogs. I just think in games, generally speaking, you never see... And I think cats would be way more terrifying if they went all aggro on you. Dogs are bigger
target.
Yeah, I
mean, because it's something that we've never really seen before, so yeah.
Not to mention, like, it would be hard to hit them. When they attack, I don't know if you've ever seen a cat attack someone, but they go right for the person's face.
Mm-hmm.
With their claws and shit. It's
their,
awesome.
Their friggin' ears go back and they squinch their face.
They're terrifying.
A little bit,
but... When they're not infected with a zombie-esque virus. Can you imagine if they were?
There was a zombie movie, I can't remember what it was, where they had like a zombie cat and just bit the fuck out of everybody. Did you fart?
No. I didn't breathe on you, though. I just ate pizza.
Why'd you breathe on me, you fucking freak?
Oh, they have farted. Nope. But you do have a fan coming in.
Yeah. So, I think I'll be fine. Mm. There's a zombie movie called Zombievers, and I swear it's the funniest thing ever. I think I've seen that, actually. Like, not actually seen it, but I've seen it around. Like, I've heard that movie before.
just thinking about the logistics that went into whoever owns this house to constructing it.
Well, if you read all the journals and stuff, it was intentionally made that way to be, like, all confusing and stuff.
Yeah.
Because they're hiding a secret lab behind this house, so.
But we don't know that yet. We are unawares.
It's aware it's a bad movie, so it's just funny. So it's kind of like Sharknadoes with zombie beavers instead of, well, Sharknadoes.
I've never seen Sharknadoes.
Sharknader, Zoe said. He said Sharknader. No, I've never seen Sharknado either, but I've seen clips of it and stuff, and it looks like a really fucking terrible movie. But, yeah, I mean, it's supposed to be. But... Yeah, it's supposed to be, though, so.
Yeah, it's one of those things. I don't like things that are intentionally bad. I like things that are accidentally bad and amazing, like The Happening.
Right. Or, The Happening. Have you ever heard of the movie The Room?
The what?
The Room with Tommy Wiseau.
What the fuck is that?
Oh my god. Oh my god, you need to see that movie. You need to see that fucking movie. I'm showing you that movie later.
Oh my god. No. My friend's drunk and now he's trying to hit on me.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, God. What am I doing? Oh, yeah.
Just gonna stop responding. That's a good choice.
That's usually what you need to do when you're...
The worst thing as a lesbian when you have guy friends and they get drunk and they're like, "You're amazing. We get along so well.
Well, the worst
I wish
thing,
you were straight."
And, well, I mean, the worst thing about that, and I'm also guilty of this because I've done it before, but when I get... like super drunk and then I text friends, sometimes girls, and I'll go like, "Oh, why don't you like me?" and stuff like that, you know what I mean?
Well, and it's like, I just want to be your friends. If you want anything
exactly.
more, I would say something. Leave it alone. It's awkward. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm not responding to him hitting on me. I'm asking other questions like, "Oh, what are you drinking?"
Yeah,
fairly
just like
obvious.
Kinda have him chill out. You know, yeah. I understand that.
Friendship is not entitlement. Being friends with you does not mean you're entitled to hit on me or entitled to me having feelings for you. Mm. Ooh. Aw, your boyfriend fell over. Oh, you can totally interpret this in like a weird boyfriend-y way. Because you'd be like, she
like
just
metaphorically?
Keeps... Yeah, metaphorically. Like, all these men be coming at her. And she just puts them down, walks away, takes her heads off. What up, Catlin? I like the way your name is. It's kind of cool.
Catlin. Mac Cat. Hello! See, it's all good now. My stream, my last stream crapped out on me, and now everyone's coming back, so that's good. That's good. I fucked up, but everything got resolved in the end. Oh yeah, look at this. Will you take the battery pack? Yeah. My black son. My black son. Man, we're all friendly in the chat, aren't we? I'm just going like, greetings, salutations.
Howdy, partner.
There's a snake in my boots.
Every time. That was great.
That was great. There's a snake in my boot. There's a boot in my snake. Ah, what the fuck? Welcome to the family, Snake. Man, why you do that? Yeah, did my screen get dark? It totally did. Why'd it do that? Mm. I don't like that.
Well, your mug's scared. In front of you.
Help me. I'm fucking scared right now.
The world is a scary place.
The world is truly a haunting place. Burn the bodies. Have you guys played The Evil Within? And if so, what do you guys think about it? I think it's pretty good. Should probably.
Don't even know what it is.
It's the spiritual successor to Resident Evil.
It's probably not.
Made by the original creator.
Yeah, I kind of got the, I got stuck in PS2 land and like never left.
You're way too nostalgic.
I love. I mean, PS2. I have so
there's
many.
Being,
games.
There's being nostalgic, and there's being too nostalgic.
I'm a collector of PS2 games. I have all of the.
Because PS2
Guitar
is like the
Heroes,
only game
Mac
system you've ever played
Power.
In your life.
Or the only one Super that you Nintendo is pretty intense too. Also, I play
yeah,
a
Nintendo
lot of games.
Really needs to go back to those days. Where
they
it's
they
like,
actually have. There's some good platforming Mario games for Wii. They actually went back and like.
Yeah, but I'm saying with all their games, not just their. You know.
I think the main issue isn't that they need to go back; it's that they stopped going forward. They stopped being unique.
I think. I mean, they're. I think they're still unique, but they're very gimmicky about it. That's the problem. Like, they're not even making games anymore. It's like they're making toys.
They are making toys, pretty much, you know.
Yeah.
That's a valid.
It's very, like, let's make, like, action figure type video games. We need to have some sort of gimmick with all of our games instead of making, you know, just a fucking game that anybody can play. Like, the best example of that is the recent Star Fox Zero. And it literally forces you to use the gamepad to look into it as, like, a cockpit.
Zelda. Bam.
Not all I'm all about is Zelda, and that's it for Nintendo. No. Yeah, me too, at this point. Because, like I said before in my last stream,
the Mario
Zelda's
games were
my
awesome for.
Yeah.
Freaking. Mario in the Super Nintendo was awesome. You had Yoshi Island, Super Mario Brothers.
Well, I was
Super
just
going to
say, like, Zelda's my other most favorite video game franchise of all time. That's the one that Nintendo really hasn't fucked up that much, you know, in terms of gimmicks. Because really the only gimmicky Zelda game that they've released was Skyward Sword. And what do you fucking know? That one happened to be one of the more mediocre titles, at least in my opinion. I know there's a lot of people that like that one, but
the
not
original
me.
Final Fantasies. Mm-hmm. They were
if
awesome.
You look at the word Nintendo for an entire day, the letters from form into Disney. Yeah, I mean, Disney. Disney, it's kind of different, because, like, at least Disney, all of their movies are, like, really good, you know? There's really been a bad Disney movie. And they don't try to fuck over, like, their audience. Whereas Nintendo is constantly dumbing things down for people. Let's see. Pump the water. Which way? Red or green? I don't remember what one I should do. I think it's red.
Did it work?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I got it. Okay, cool. I knew it was supposed to be red. At least the new Zelda, Breath of the Wild, looks really good, so I'm excited for that one. I'm really glad that they're going with the whole open world thing instead of it being another linear Zelda game that been kind of going on for the past few years. I'm glad they're doing the whole open world thing again. And I'm also glad that Resident Evil is going back to its survival horror roots. So, Nintendo infected by the powerful Konami virus. Code Konami virus, sorry. Kind of like the Code Veronica virus. I don't think Nintendo's gotten that far. Hopefully the new CEO knows what they're fucking doing. I mean, because Nintendo has done some pretty shitty things recently, but they're not nearly as bad as Konami. Konami can literally eat a bag of dicks. Like, whoever's in charge of Konami right now really needs to be fired. But alas, we know that that's not going to happen. Keeper's Diary. Played poker tonight with Scott and Elias from security and Steve from research. Steve was a big winner, but I think he was cheating, scumbag. One of the higher-ups assigned... Like, okay, real talk. This journal entry right here is probably one of the more memorable parts of the first Resident Evil. Like, it's so iconic that a lot of people have, like, often... quoted this entire thing when they talk about Resident Evil. One of the higher-ups assigned me to take care of a new creature. It looks like a skinned gorilla. Feeding instructions were to give it live animals. When I threw in a pig, the creature seemed to play with it, tearing off the pig's legs and pulling out the guts before starting to actually eat it. At around 5 a.m., Scott woke me up. Scared the shit out of me, too. He was wearing a protective suit. He handed me another one and told me to put it on. Said there'd been an accident in the basement lab. I knew something like this would happen. Those bastards in research never sleep, even on holiday. May 12th, 1998. I've been wearing the damn spacesuit since yesterday. My skin's getting all grimy and feels itchy all over. Goddamn dogs have been looking at me funny, so I decided not to feed them today. Screw them. May 13th, 1998. Went to the infirmary because my back is all swollen and feels itchy. They put a big bandage on it and told me I didn't need to wear the suit anymore. All I want to do is sleep. May 14th, 1998. Found another big blister on my foot this morning. Ended up dragging my foot all the way to the dog's pen. They were all quiet today, which is weird. Then I realized that some of them had escaped. Maybe this is their way of getting back at me for not feeding them the last 3 days. If anybody finds out, I'll have my head handed to me. May 16th, 1998. Rumors going around that the researcher who tried to escape the estate last night was shot. My entire body feels hot and itchy, and I'm sweating all over all the time now. I scratched the swelling on my arm, and a piece of rotten flesh just dropped off. What the hell is happening to me? May 19th, 1998. Fever gone, but itchy. Today, hungry and eat doggy food. May 21st, 1998. Itchy. Scott came, ugly face, so killed him. Tasty. Itchy. Tasty.
Your boyfriend's here. I mean, he seems a little needy, though. Thanks.
Just a little.
Oh, God. Hopefully Resident Evil's going back to its roots. Demo might have just been to show off the engine. I mean, yeah, that is what they said. They did say that they also wanted to showcase the atmosphere that they were going with. So, It's definitely gonna be, and they said that even though the demo isn't going to be in the final game, the demo is still canonical. Yeah, it's still canonical to the series. And it is a prequel to the actual Resident Evil 7. So the events did happen. It's not just like, oh, well, we're only doing this to showcase the engine. Like, it is part of the Resident Evil universe now, so. Which is cool. Threesome. Oh, yeah. Oh. Hi. Ah! Itchy. Tasty. Get this in there. Oh, yeah. Why, thank you. Ashley is coming back, mate. Maybe sometime down the line. I doubt she's gonna come back in 7, though. Because they said that in Resident Evil 7, it's going to be an entirely new cast of characters. Like, none of the original Resident Evil characters are going to be returning, as far as we know. They said that maybe they'll appear as cameos, but they're not going to be playable. Nor are they going to be integral to the story. So, yeah. Which is fine by me, because, like, honestly, like, Resident Evil really does need a fresh start. So I'm all for that. It's funny how people were really pissed off at, like, the whole, oh, Devil May Cry getting a reboot, oh no. And, you know, they made the Devil May Cry reboot, and I'm like, why didn't they just fucking make a reboot of Resident Evil? That's the game that really needed to be rebooted. And now that Resident Evil 7 is coming out, it's really kind of a reboot. I mean, it's still a continuation, but, it feels completely different from the past few games. Ada-thong, sorry, Ada-kong, or is it Ada-dong? I think it's Ada-shlong. I think that's the correct one. That's the one with the eyes. I cannot see a weevil. Ada Dong. Man, you ate a dong. You ate a dong last night, probably. Whoa. Sick burn, bro. Fist bump my N-word. Let's see here. Where do I use the key this time? I know there's like at least one more door I haven't used yet. Emblem of a helmet. Can't remember which door I needed to go through next. Eat that. Smoke some herb, man. La da 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 da. It's the motherfucking D-O-double-G Snoop Dogg. There we go. There's another use for the armor key. La da da da. You know I'm all about the D-R-E. Smoke weed every day. Forest. Not forest. Tell me some resident jokes. Or lore. I don't really know any Resident Evil jokes offhand, but, I can tell you a little bit of lore, I guess. Hold on, just give me a sec here. Gotta blow Forest up. Poor Forest. Make it so. I don't know, like, what do you want to know about the lore of Resident Evil? Because I could literally tell you anything, but... Like, what do you want to know? What do you want to know that you haven't heard about, like, Resident Evil lore that you want to know about? Herbs. I do know that the herbs in the Resident Evil universe, the ones that you use, are mainly grown in the Arklay Mountain region. I don't know if that's the case for all the herbs in all the Resident Evil games, but I know that the herbs that you get in the first three games are from the Arklay Mountain region. They're natively grown here. And I think all the other herbs in the other games are similar and have similar medical properties. But aren't the same. Store some shit real quick. What else would you like to know, Catelyn? testing me. Alright, well, give me a hard one then. Give me a challenge, something I can work with. Let's get rid of the handgun for now. Probably herb. I'll put my shotgun back here. Founders of Umbrella. Alright, there's three separate founders. One of them was Oswald E. Spencer, James Marcus, and I believe James Marcus, Oswald E. Spencer, and, God, I know this one, fuck. William Birkin would have been too young. So would Albert Wesker. I don't even think William Birkin was born at that time when Umbrella was founded. Let's see, James Marcus, Oswald E. Spencer. That's right, Edward Ashford, yeah. And then Oswald E. Spencer betrayed both James Marcus and Edward Ashford. And, Oswald E. Spencer conspired against James Marcus specifically. He sent Albert Wesker and William Birkin to kill James Marcus. And then James Marcus got resurrected by the leeches that he was experimenting on. So that kind of backfired on him, on his part. And then we all know what happened to Oswald E. Spencer way later, when Umbrella was coming under fire from all the shit that was happening on Raccoon City, and he had to testify in court after the whole Raccoon City incident. Albert Wesker testified against Oswald E. Spencer. Basically betraying him, and he did this so that way, Umbrella would fall, and Albert Wesker could get his hands on tons of research material and data. Which also was a big surprise to Oswald E. Spencer, because he thought that Albert Wesker died along with the mansion. So, Spencer is not Albert Wesker's father. Albert Wesker's father and Spencer were very close, though. But no, Spencer and Wesker are not related by blood. I could see that, yeah. I don't, like, my theory on it is that, maybe the plantation that's the main setting of Resident Evil 7 was also a secret umbrella facility and was like abandoned or something for whatever reason after the fall of Umbrella. And maybe some of the creatures or the experiments weren't properly disposed of and managed to leak out, basically. That, or either the plantation was used as some sort of like a guinea pig experiment, and Umbrella used the inhabitants of said plantation as their guinea pigs for an experiment. That's why you saw the picture of the helicopter in the demo. Because they were secretly watching them and all that stuff. Like a very, like, draconian, almost Orwellian sort of surveillance, you know what I mean? Because they were secretly being experimented on. See, I think that would be kind of fucking creepy and fucked up. And I wouldn't put it past them if that was the thing. I haven't seen Umbrella for some time. Yeah, and it should probably stay that way, honestly, because like the whole Neo Umbrella shit in Resident Evil 6 was fucking it was stupid. It was a stupid plot point. So I hope that they just keep Umbrella in the past. Maybe like, you know, you're in that plantation for whatever reason, and you're exploring like an abandoned Umbrella facility or something like that. Umbrella must have had an abundance of funding to have all of these facilities scattered all over the planet. Dude, Umbrella was literally everywhere.
It was like owned by every rich family in the world. It was like,
I mean, not really. I feel like it was really probably. Like, Umbrella's influence was all over the world.
It I believe it's probably funded by, like, the stock options alone and funding something like that would be insane.
Like, Umbrella was the biggest corporation, pharmaceutical corporation. And, it was the leader of, medical products and, you know, healthcare throughout the entire world. And according to the lore of Resident Evil, when they were found out that they were behind the whole Raccoon City incident, and, you know, the corporation fell and all that, it was a huge hit. They took a huge hit, publicity-wise. And it was one of those events where, just, like, they had this corporation that people trusted so much that was ingrained in everyone's lives that everybody, virtually everyone across the world has used an Umbrella product at one point in their lives. And to have such a huge corporation come under that much scrutiny, to be under that much controversy, was just a world-shattering event. And not only did it, Umbrella's fall encourage these people, like terrorist organizations, to use their research for bioterrorism, but it also lost, like, a lot of trust of corporations in general in the world of Resident Evil.
It was kind of like during the stock market crash in the 50s, mm-hmm. when everyone, and then people started keeping all their money and like freaking their mattresses the 30s. And shit.
You said 50s, it was whatever. Actually the 30s. But, yeah, No, yeah, it is kind of like that.
Same principle. They kept in their mattresses because they didn't think they could trust banks anymore.
Honestly, and it kind of parallels with our world, too, in a way. The fact that, you know, because we have a lot of corporate distrust amongst the populace. Like, nobody trusts corporations today. Because a lot of corporations have done really shitty things to us in the past. And still continue to do shitty things. I mean, look at fucking Konami, for fuck's sake. And EA. Or Goldman Sachs. Or, you know, Time Warner and shit like that. All these corporations doing these shitty, shitty things to people. Financially or otherwise. Nobody trusts corporations anymore. Walmart, you know, with their fucking sweatshops across different countries, you know, fucking virtually hiring slaves, you know what I mean? Child workers and stuff like that. Yeah, you know, nobody fucking trusts corporations anymore because of all the shitty shit. Companies at one point that we used to trust wholeheartedly. It's fucking crazy, man.
I don't know anything about Konami, so...
Just Konami has fucked people in the past.
It's kind of like how EA has killed people.
What? I don't know about that, but...
No, not like with the knife, but they have this... They'd have flaws in their games where, like, multiple charge people. Right? So you have people who are in bed rest or restricted to bed who like to play games... And they would, like, put their credit card information on. And then there would be glitches, and they knew about it. EA Game knew about the glitches, let them go on. So it would drain their accounts eventually. And then, like, they would turn off their electricity. People have died. Literally, people have died. And EA has been called and reported about it. There's, like, a huge statement from a guy who used to work for him online that I read. And, they knew about it.
I've never heard of this, and this sounds way too bad shit to be true.
No, it's true.
I don't know, like, I don't know if EA has, like, inadvertently killed people before, but, like...
Give me a second, I'll look it up, and I will read it to you.
Okay. New York City incident happened. What does that mean? What are you talking about, New York City incident? I mean, I don't even know where the fuck to go. I'm going in circles. Oh, you know what? I'm a fucking idiot. I know where to go now. Silent Hill PT never. Well, I mean... We're kind of getting Silent Hills. It's called Death Stranding now. Like Raccoon City. Yeah, I mean, I used to believe in the whole, like, oh, zombies, it's a possibility. It's not really. Like, I think the closest we'll ever get to, like, a zombie apocalypse is something like a fucking smallpox outbreak. Or everybody will just get sick and die. Like, none of the reanimating corpses or anything like that, but, you know. And honestly, it's a lot more scary. Because, like, with zombies, like, in the movies, they treat, like, zombie apocalypses are, like, very, like, oh my god, how cataclysmic. It would be the end of civilization as we know it. But if we were to look at, like, zombie outbreaks actually happening in real life, zombie outbreaks could be really easy to contain. Because think about it. In the movies, zombie viruses are, for the most part, bloodborne viruses. And the only way that you could get infected is through a bite. And the fact that everyone knows how to kill a zombie in the first place, you shoot it in the head, and they're very slow, and really, taking all those factors into account, zombies are a pretty fucking easy threat to contain. You can't contain an airborne virus that easily. You can't contain a waterborne virus that easily. Especially when it goes through, like, the water pipes in the city or some shit. You know what I mean? So, that's a lot more scary than a bloodborne virus. Like, which is why I'm not fucking scared of Ebola like a lot of people are. Because Ebola is a very easy virus to contain. And, nobody should be afraid of Ebola, because, like, you have a very, very low chance of ever getting infected by it. But anyway, yeah. Zombie viruses, even if it were a real thing, even if it were a possibility, it would not end the world. Unless if we were extremely incompetent at fucking trying to contain it. Like, it's just freak accident after freak accident, which is unrealistic. If anything, airborne viruses would destroy us all. Like, something like the bubonic plague. If we ever had that again, we'd all be fucked. Oh yeah, dude, like, military action, you bet your fucking ass, man. Like, the threat of a zombie apocalypse would be virtually non-existent. Res 7 better be a third person. They already confirmed it would be, first person. Like, it's gonna be entirely in first person. First person only worked for Umbrella Chronicles and Darkseid. To be honest, like, dude, Resident Evil Umbrella Chronicles and Darkseid Chronicles are extremely fun. I have both of them.
I retract my previous statement. It was an anonymous statement by someone who claimed to be an EA person.
Yeah, said that. Yeah.
But still, it's alright. Like, there's multiple statements online about them draining their accounts with billionaires and EA basically not doing anything about it or wanting to fix anything.
I can see that.
Like, there's a guy in here who's like, yeah, they took, you know, $300 of my money before I noticed it with a glitching error on one of their games on expenses.
Yeah, but...
And then I called them and they basically said...
But the problem with that is that how are you going to prove that they actually did that out of malicious intent?
No, they don't do it out of malicious intent. They just purposely don't fix it because they know they're getting money out of it.
Sure, yeah.
They're purposely not fixing something that's screwing over lots of their companies. You can see that all over the place.
I don't mind first person, it could work. Actually, here's a little bit of trivia for you. The original Resident Evil was originally supposed to be in first person, but they couldn't make the game in first person because of technical limitations. They couldn't even have it like a third person game, even. They had to do the whole like fixed camera angles things, because that was the only way that the game would work. Because all the other methods of control was, like, fucking hard to work with.
God, they have a shit ton of billion errors. I just looked it up and it's, like, list, like, Mythic billionaire, Star Wars billionaire, FIFA billionaire. They just want to steal your shit and they don't give a fuck.
You said FIFA. It's FIFA.
Whatever. I'm a hockey person. I like hockey. And I still wouldn't play a hockey game.
Honestly, I think that horror works best in first person. Because, like, a really big thing about horror games is the immersion. And I'm a lot more immersed when I'm actually looking at it through the eyes of the player character. So first person works extremely well with horror games, and I think it would work really well with Resident Evil. It
smells like man in here, like a sexy man. Because of your candle. The moonlit night.
Smoke weed every day.
La da 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 da. It's the motherfucking DLWG.
I don't know, I kind of like the Resident Evil 7 one that you're playing, but if it's that difficult in the Resident Evil, when they release Resident Evil 7, I probably won't want to play it. But is I like the storyline-ish. Welcome to the family, son.
Welcome to the family, son.
Guess it would be easier to get spooked without an entire field view. Yeah, like, seriously. Because if you can see, like, the horror coming, like, if you can see, like, the scary shit coming, it's not nearly as effective. I mean, there are games that do work in third person, like Silent Hill, for example, where it works really good in third person, just because the atmosphere is just so thick, and it's so thick that you could cut it with a fucking knife, you know what I mean? And it works for that particular game.
And that's interesting. I wonder how many people are going to, like, get heart attacks or die while playing scary games because of VR.
Yeah, seriously. It was interesting that Resident Evil was supposed to be a sequel to Japanese horror game Sweet Home. Yeah, that's true too, actually. Sweet Home was also a movie. And I've seen the movie a long time ago. It was actually pretty neat. Playing it in VR would give someone a heart attack, I think. Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised. Honestly. I think I've read a news story that someone had a heart attack while playing PT. He survived, but it's still pretty crazy to think that someone actually said, I got a fucking heart attack while playing that game. It almost killed me.
Just wait for the first person to try to sue, like, a game company because they get a heart attack playing their game or die. Or their loved one dies.
Right, yeah.
That's gonna happen.
It's like, this game is too scary. You killed my husband. Well, how old is he, man? He was 87 years old. It's like, well, did he have a pre-existing heart condition? It's like, yes. It's like, well, then he had, didn't have to fucking play the game yet, then.
If the company, really, like, puts it, kind of like when they have seizure warnings, they should do that with heart conditions for VR.
I think they already do that with horror games, anyway. Like, there are some horror games out there that give you warnings, like, saying, like, hey, if you guys got a heart condition, don't play this.
We will kill you, and we will miss your money from your death.
You will die to death. I will kill you so hard that you will die to death. Where the fuck do I go? I can't remember.
Look at
your
journal.
Such a klutz. Huh?
I don't know. Is there a journal system or like.
No.
Anything that tells you where you're going?
Nope. I bet now that the name PT even, like, I bet now that the name PT even comes up, that guy has a heart attack just by hearing it. Yeah. Oh geez, I imagine the nightmares that guy must have had.
I've never, yeah. What is PT anyway?
I can show it to you later. It's the Silent Hills demo.
Oop, nope, no thank you.
It's fuck like it's
I'm directly opposed
it's the
to
scariest. It's one of the scariest games I've ever played in my life. That fucking game genuinely terrified me. Like, games like Resident Evil don't really scare me, but I really enjoy the atmosphere and the story and the gameplay. But they've never really scared me. Like, I've never really had a video game that actually genuinely scared me. PT was one of those games that I was legitimately fucking terrified by. I was like, oh my, what is this fucking game? Like, Hideo Kojima, man, like, He even said, like that was his first horror game that he's ever made, you know? Like, straight up horror. And for a first attempt, like, fucking give him props, man. Like, the guy's a fucking genius. What am I fucking doing? Jesus. I'm sorry, guys. I don't mean to fucking be... I don't mean for you guys to, like, look at a whole bunch of nothing playing this game. Because I have no idea what the fuck to do. I'm trying to think. Too bad we will never see it in the form of what Silent Hills was going to be. I wish it wasn't canceled. You know what? I think that Hideo Kojima is pretty much making Silent Hills with Death Stranding. You know, just with a different name. Death Stranding. I'm pretty sure that it is Silent Hills, just with a different name. I wouldn't be surprised. I don't know what I'm fucking doing. Oh, now I remember. I know where to go now. I wish it wasn't canceled. Yeah. Dude, I was really pissed off when I found out it was canceled. I mean, everyone was, but, like, I was especially pissed off. Like, I could not get over it for, like, the next few months because of it. I think, like, it took me an entire year to get over it fully. Like, yeah, it's never coming back. I think what finally sealed the deal for me, like, okay, the game is never gonna see the light of day, was when Hideo Kojima didn't go to the Video Game Awards. Because Konami told them not to, or else there would be legal action against him, which was bullshit, too. Another reason why Konami's just full of evil assholes. PT left me spooked and paranoid. Then I got jump scared so hard, didn't help that I was playing in the dark either. Yeah, I heard about PT because it was just absolutely blowing up on YouTube. Like, people were fucking playing it and stuff just all over the place. And I was like, what the hell is PT? And at that point, no one knew it was Silent Hills. Like, because of that whole mystery surrounding it. And, so I'm like, I want to play this. This seems like it's really scary. I didn't see any video footage of it or anything either. Like, I only saw screenshots. So I'm like, I'm going to check this out. I started playing it, and my brother and I were playing it together. And, like, I could not sleep that night. Because of how fucking spooked out I was by it. Like, that game genuinely fucking terrified me. And then, I think the following night, there was a streamer that found out that it was actually the playable teaser for the new Silent Hill game. Called Silent Hills, directed by Hideo Kojima, Guillermo del Toro, and starring Norman Reedus. And everyone was like, oh my god, no fucking way, and I was excited for it. Unfortunately, it'll never make it past the demo stage. Like I said, though, Death Stranding is Silent Hills.
It looks similar.
It pretty much, like, because Hideo Kojima even said he wanted to make a horror game. He really wanted to make a horror game. And, I think, I'm pretty sure that's what he's doing now. He's still doing the, Silent Hills, just under a different name, to avoid legal action. Because Norman Reedus is still in it. he's still starring in this game, and he's still getting the help of Junji Ito, who also worked on Silent Hills PT. And Guillermo del Toro said that he would think about joining in, too, so... There's that, you know. I just finished Metal Gear Solid 5 yesterday, and it blew my mind, even though I wasn't, even though it wasn't the original ending, it made sense in the end. Like you mentioned earlier, there's that one game, I keep forgetting the name. With all the games, when it comes to Kojima, he's nuts. Yeah, like, Kojima's a fucking genius, man. Like, seriously, he knows what the fuck he's doing. Okay. Yeah, man, I can't wait for Norman Reedus and the Funky Fetus.
That was clever. He's such an ugly crier, though. Can we just go over the fact that, like...
Yeah.
That whole part where he's crying, and I'm just like, oh, honey, no, you are a really ugly crier. Like... just no.
Norman, please, don't.
Stop crying, Norman.
It'll all be okay.
You're always getting so emotional.
Another reason why I think it is going to be Silent Hills under a different name is because, yeah, it for one, it looks all fucked up, Death Stranding. And both PT and Death Stranding had a weird fetus in it, so. Along with Norman Reedus.
What?
What?
I'm just looking at you.
You were looking at me.
Yeah, you said something and I looked over. That's kind of how attention works.
My cousin's coming on to me, isn't that weird?
Ew. I'm not, you freak. I think you're grounded.
Oh, I'm grounded, okay.
I'll tell your mom.
Man, yeah, like, you know, like I said, I hope it's a horror game. That'd be fucking nuts. I'm pretty sure it will be, because Hideo Kojima, like I said, he does want to make a horror game. He's been wanting to make a horror game for a long time. Since before Metal Gear Solid 4, so... And yes, I did say 4. He like, when I say he wanted to make one for a long time, yeah, he really wanted to make one. It was action adventure more so, but maybe it'll have horror too. I don't know if he's. Has it been confirmed? Because I've heard that too, and I heard that that hasn't really been confirmed yet. No one really knows what Death Stranding's gonna be. Looks like he'll be filling my horror game void with the indie horrors and the older Silent Hill RE titles until RE7 and. DS releases. Oh, Death Stranding. Okay. Yeah, like I said, I don't know if it's actually been confirmed that it's action-adventure. I think that people have said that. I don't think that Hideo Kojima himself has said that. What the fuck? Where am I going? It's like when I start talking,
Your brain turns off?
Like, my brain turns off, and I completely, like, forget what I'm actually doing. I gotta go down here and go back to that fucking piano room.
Hey, it's Incognitus. I like
Incognitus. Incognitus. Damn it, we're supposed to be Incognitus.
I'm really excited about the Lone Wanderer. Is that what he's called?
What?
Lone Wanderer, the thing from the E3.
You mean Days Gone?
Yeah, that thing.
Lone Wanderer, you are way
I've been reading a lot of game
Holy
titles online.
Fuck.
I was sitting around on Steam, and I get game titles.
Lone Wanderer.
Whatever. Days Gone looks good.
Yeah.
Regardless. And I'm pretty sure it's the same actor that played from Star Wars Force Unleashed.
The
same visual actor.
Poe Dameron?
I don't know. He's
That's the fighter pilot?
The main guy.
He's not the main guy.
I'm talking about the main guy.
Oh.
From Force Unleashed, the actual guy?
No, he's not the main guy. The main guy is Finn. And he's black. The main character from Days Gone is not black.
I'm not Star Wars Force Unleashed, dear.
Oh!
What the fuck are you talking about?
I'm thinking of The Force Awakens. I'm
no,
sorry.
No, Force Unleashed.
God damn it, I'm a fucking moron.
It's the same guy. He also is in that werewolf vampire movie show thing that was
on.
I don't remember what it's called.
Force Unleashed.
He's really pretty, though.
Action adventure? Hope not. I've played enough action adventure games disguised as horror games. Trevor's diary. 11 days have passed since arriving on this estate. How did it end up like this? A guy in a lab coat brought me in a meager plate of food and said, "Sorry to put you through this, but it's for security reasons." That's when it hit me. It all made sense now. Hold on, I need to read this guy's comment real quick. Ghost Recon Wildlands, of course, because Ubisoft's all downgraded a lot. Yeah. And I hate that whole fucking stuff where, like, you know how they script players talking to each other? You know? As Jimquisition would call it, the mic drop, I think he said. Or the mic effect, I don't know. Where people would, at Ubisoft, during E3, would put up these gameplay demos, and have people talking to each other, and you can tell it's clearly scripted, what they're saying. That it's clearly not them actually, like, talking to each other like normal fucking human beings. And they're all saying shit to each other that no one would be saying when playing a game like that. Like, taking it too seriously and stuff like that. It's just like, you know, friends playing with each other would not talk like that. You know what I mean? They did that same shit with the Division demo a couple years ago. I feel perfectly safe playing as a guy who can punch boulders. Exactly. Like, in Resident Evil 7, if you're playing as Chris Redfield or Leon Kennedy in that game, it wouldn't nearly be as scary. Because they've had experience throughout all this shit. And to have them suddenly be in a horror environment again, wouldn't make any sense. Because they've dealt with that before. They know what they're dealing with, and it wouldn't be scary to them anymore. What I don't understand is that the consoles handle the details and the tech for the engine to run on them, or what? Oh, can the consoles handle the details in the engine? If it's optimized well, sure. I mean, it's not going to be like a full 60 frames a second or anything like that. Probably not. I'm not gonna say, I'm not gonna read all that. I'm gonna keep it entertaining for you guys. I mean, there's games like Metal Gear Solid 5 where they use the Fox engine, and that's an open world game, and they were perfectly able to make that game 60 frames. It's all about optimization, really. Depends on what kind of engine they're using. If the engine is well equipped to deal with that sort of console. And the Xbox One and the PS4 are very relatively underpowered consoles. Right now, they're already underpowered. Like, honestly, their Xbox 360s and PS3s slightly upgraded, really. I mean, sure, they're a bit more powerful, but not by much. You might as well just get a fucking PC instead, honestly. Like, the only reason why I have a PS4 and Xbox One is for a couple reasons. One, I'm a collector. I like collecting video games. And two, for the exclusives. Like, I wanted to get a PS4 just for Bloodborne. And I wanted to get the Xbox One for games like Halo and Gears of War. Even though Halo is fucking ridiculous now. Like, Halo 5 is garbage. But at least there's the Master Chief Collection, which is fixed now, thank God. And Gears 4 looks pretty sweet. Not expecting too much, but it looks alright. They're not optimizing it well enough, because these are pretty huge fucking games. And to optimize these huge games with this amount of detail onto a really underpowered console is not really an easy thing to do. If they made these games like exclusive to PC, then it would be a lot easier for them. But they're still dealing with very underpowered consoles. So optimization is extremely hard. I mean, it's doable, but it's a very time-consuming process. That's why it took so long for Metal Gear Solid 5 to come out. It's because of those issues. And there was also some other things to take into account, too, because they wanted to put that game on many platforms as possible. Because not only did they put them on the Xbox One, PS4, and PC, they also put it on the PS3 and the 360. So they had even more optimization problems to deal with. And it's kind of funny, because the Fox engine is supposedly a very easy engine to use. It's an engine that costed millions of dollars to make, and it was supposed to be very user-friendly. A lot like the Unreal Engine or the Unity Engine.
Hey, you figured out what you're doing.
And unfortunately, we're probably never going to see another Fox Engine game ever again, because fucking Konami. They don't want to actually fucking make any games anymore. By damn, it looks amazing on the old gen consoles. Frame rate has problems, but looks great. You mean Metal Gear Solid 5? Yeah, it still looks really good on the old gen consoles, but it still has to be run on 30 frames. Yeah, that's exactly what it was meant to be used for. The Fox engine was created to be put on as many platforms as possible. And, I mean, fuck, they managed to get that right, so. The Fox engine's a really impressive engine, it really is. And it's a fucking damn shame that we're never gonna see a game on the Fox engine ever again, most likely. Guys, ready to fight the snake? I'm gonna be fighting the snake.
Seems like a metaphor for straight sex.
We're fighting the snake.
Okay, you gotta kill it.
You gotta kill the snake. And yeah, too bad we won't see something like that with the Titan engine, because it really is an engine that goes miles with that next. What? It really is an engine. It goes miles with that. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, the engine is fucking beautiful, man. Like, the box engine's really, really nice. And it's funny, because even though Kojima and other people worked on that engine, it's still Konami's property. And Konami is never going to give it to anybody. They're going to keep that shit with them. It's like, oh, well, we need this Fox engine to make our trailers for our pachinko machines, hardy, hardy, heart. Because, you know, they're fucking assholes. Yeah, the PlayStation chat log really likes to separate the words from each other. Hey, Mac-a-cat, where the fuck'd you go? You were gone for like literally an hour, probably. There's a dead Richard on the floor. You guys, there's a dead dick on the floor. Felix.
Meow. 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 Meow.
What do you want? Huh? Say hello. Say hello to the chat.
Meow.
Come here, buddy. Say hello. He's like, oh, I don't know what's going on. Why, you good boy?
Needy McKitty Pants.
He is a needy McKitty Pants. He's a kitty kitty. Oh, you gotta do laundry? That's a pain in the ass, isn't it? To think they hold all these franchises and do jack fucking shit with them. Mobile games are the way of the future, my ass. Yeah. Mobile games are great and all, but I don't think that they are the future. I don't think they are the future of gaming. I think that's a very, very naive thing to say.
They hold all those franchises and do nothing with them. Holy shit. Speak parcel! Speak parcel tongue!
Parcel tongue.
Stop trying to flay me. Yeah, speak parcel.
Ah, fuck. I'm poisoned. Speaking parcel tongue. Oh, he's leaving. Fuck yourself. Fucking snake. You're loud. You're a loud purr.
Serum.
Barry!
Kill the snake?
Yep. But I guess all y'all can do is spread fuck Konami, hashtag fuck Konami, but not buy their shit, not even for a dime, and hope that one day we might see these games right spot. Hopefully. I think that's also kind of unrealistic to a certain extent. Because Konami is also a very, very rich company in and of itself.
And people still keep buying it.
Like, I could see people not buying any of their video game shit or any of their mobile game shit, but they still have other things to keep them going. Like, they still have their pachinko machines that are really popular in Japan. They still have their Yu-Gi-Oh cards, which Yu-Gi-Oh is owned by Konami. they still have, they still make their water bottles, which they make fucking water bottles. And they have, yeah, it is random. And they have, what's it called?
Channel the Herbies?
No, they got, like, yeah, I mean, probably. They have, like, gyms and stuff, like workout gyms.
Oh, I thought, God, you freaked me out, cat.
Ah! There's a crimson head. White water bottles? I think it has something to do with the fact that they own, like, gyms and stuff and, like, you know, workout places and all that. So they sell water bottles at those places and stuff.
There's no such thing as too much money.
Exactly. They also own a couple of anime franchises, I believe, as well. And they sell toys. Similar to, like, Play Arts figures by Square Enix. They sell their own action figures that, are exclusive to Japan. So they got a really decent-sized market in Japan. Yeah, they own gyms. They're all located in Japan, though. They also, they have, slot machines over here in America. I was actually at a casino not too long ago, and they've got Konami branded slot machines over in North America.
Are they like anime themed?
No, they're just like they have like different themes. Like I think they made like a Lord of the Rings slot machine and stuff.
Kidding me right now, Felix.
Felix, don't be annoying. Quit brushing your tail on my face.
He's brushing his face on my elbow while I'm trying to tail. Shoot people.
You got a squirrel tail, Felix. He's like, oh God, give me attention, please. Oh.
No one's giving me attention for hours.
But yeah, you gotta keep in mind, like, Konami, they have a much, much bigger presence over in Japan than they do over here. And plus, they pulled out of the New York Stock Exchange as well, so their economic presence over here is a lot smaller now than it was just a couple of years ago. I mean, they still own Yu-Gi-Oh! Like, they still sell Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards and stuff here because they know it's profitable here because there's a sizable fan
base.
They
own Yu-Gi-Oh! That explains why they're rich as fuck.
Yep, they own Yu-Gi-Oh!
Yu-Gi-Oh! Has made insane money.
And they also own the anime franchise, too, so there's that. And,
well, of course, you can't own the cards without owning the game.
Yeah. So, yeah, there's that.
That explains why I hate Yu-Gi-Oh! Fucking Yu-Gi-Oh!
He licks the cat. Wonderful, wonderful cat.
Oh, he's nice. Evil, evil cat. He's bent on your destruction. He told me the other day he was just waiting for you to sleep at the right time so he could kill you.
I love how I stopped petting him and he's like brushing up against my arm. He's like, no, keep doing it. I want you to pet me. Pet me more.
I like when he purposely like bumps your arm when he knows you're playing the game.
My cats at home do that too.
They're like, oh, you're not giving me attention, but you're giving me attention. Game attention.
Especially Ellie, she'll climb up on you, like, onto your chest and start kneading you while you're playing, like, Dark Souls or something. Boobs. She likes to cop a feel, what can I say? My boobs are huge.
Seriously. He knows what girls like. He knows what girls want. Girls like boobs.
Girls do like boobs. I know plenty of girls. Like, gay or straight, they all like boobs.
Boobs are fun.
Boobs are fun. You'd be lying to yourself if you said they weren't.
No gay guys that love boobs.
Exactly! Yeah. Everybody loves boobs! Everybody!
Everybody?
Everyone. And if you don't like boobs, there's something medically wrong with you. No. If you don't like boobs, there's something medically wrong with you.
Japanese. I don't like boobs in Japanese.
Well, no, fucking Japan loves boobs. Are you kidding me?
Oh, yeah.
The Japanese really love boobs.
Implants are a thing, like, they're, like, crazy.
What?
Boob implants are really big there.
I believe it. Well, have you looked at my mouse pad? I got that from Japan. Fucking, like, the wrist rest on it, or whatever you call that, the wrist cushion, are boobs.
I know,
they're
I'm gonna give you
boobs.
The butt one, the guy's butt one. That's my goal.
Agreed, boobs are awesome. See? There's a girl in here who says that boobs are awesome.
If anything, just because you can control men with them.
Yeah, but you can control girls with boobs too, so.
Yeah, but men are so much easier to control with boobs.
Well, I mean, yeah, because, like.
Because they're like boobs.
Because boobs, they're, like, we're biologically, predisposed to liking boobs a lot.
Those are how you feed the babies.
God damn it, Felix. Now my face is all itchy because I can feel like little strands of your hair on my face. You're a bad kitty. Bad kitty, Felix. Alright, you guys, I'm gonna call it a night. I'm gonna go back to my nearest safe point. I hate it when you feel like there's cat hair on your nose, but it's actually not there. Yeah, I hate that too. I get that feeling all the time. Ah, doggies. I used to have that feeling all the time when I lived with a whole bunch of cats. Like, I used to have three cats living with me at a given time. Now I only have one. I mean, technically, Felix isn't mine, but,
my cat.
Yeah. They're technically, you know, Felix is technically, Mariah's cat, but I feel like he's my own, too. Because
that's
he chills
fine.
With me all the time.
If you want to give him attention so I don't have to, that's fine. Not that
I just love cats. I love animals in general, so whenever I have, like, an animal just, like, chilling next to me, I'm like, you're my friend. I love you. You're my friend. And more often than not, they reciprocate that feeling, so. State spray. I'm an idiot. Okay. Oh. Hi there. It's fucking dusty in here, I just realized.
Your mom's duster. Dusty.
Your vagina is dusty. Oh, we're fucking morons.
Yeah. It's genetic. This is funny, because I don't think we're actually genetically linked at all.
We are, sort of.
Very, very loosely.
Yeah.
I mean, our parents are all, like, your dad is my mom's stepbrother.
Mm-hmm. They are, like, my dad and her mom are related by blood very distantly, though. Yeah. So, in turn, you and I are very distantly related by blood, too, so.
Yep. Our family's weird.
Yeah. Where's my fucking ink? Oh, I'm sorry. Right there. Duh. Alright, you guys. I'm afraid we must part ways tonight. It's been really awesome talking with you guys. Like, even if it was only just a few of you, like, I really enjoyed doing the stream tonight. And,
hope we get to see you again.
No, we will see you again, hopefully. I'll probably be streaming again tomorrow.
But what will
either,
you stream?
Either continuing this game, or maybe playing something else, maybe get another shot of Resident Evil 7 demo, probably. I don't know. We'll see what happens. But thank you guys for stopping by, watching my stream. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, go on ahead and do that if you want. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Oh, shit.